Good morning everyone and welcome to day two of New York. This morning I've come to Applebee's in New York City and this is what I've got for breakfast. I've got bacon, pancakes, one of my brother's sausage patties, and I've got some maple syrup to go with that too. So I am going to tuck into this and enjoy it, and I'll update you later and tell you what I'm doing for the rest of my day. So right now I'm outside Carlo's Bakery in New York City. I went to the Las Vegas store, but I didn't buy anything from there. But hopefully I shall get something in here, so let's go in and check it out. So right now, I'm actually in Carlo's Bakery, and look at all this amazing stuff. It looks absolutely delicious. So I'm gonna go and order me food. I'm gonna order me cooker, and I'll get back to you and show you what it looks like when I get it. So all the bakers in Carlo's Bakery are doing fresh stuff, ready for the shop floor. Sorry about the cut off then, my order was ready, I had to pick it up. Look at everyone doing the fresh stuff. She's putting sprinkles on some donuts, I think. And he's making new cookies. Look at all them sprinkles. Oh, good swimming that. This shop's amazing. If any of you's come to New York, you've got to come here. If you like Kate Boss like I do, oh yeah, love that show. Anyway, I'm gonna go because I'm gonna go to Central Park and other places, so I will update you when I get there. So I've just come back from Carlo's Bakery and this is what I've got. I've got an M&M cookie. Look at all them M&Ms in there. Whoa. Yummy, yummy, yummy. And I have a chocolate donut, which smells absolutely amazing. This only came up to like $6, so really not that bad. So I'm gonna tuck into this cookie first. So yeah, I'm gonna enjoy it and I'll see you later. So right now I'm at Grand Central Station. Look at this ceiling. There was a documentary on a few weeks ago.
New York City.
And some presenters came here and did a documentary. It was really, really good about New York City. This is absolutely crazy. One of the busiest stations in New York. What an experience to be here. It's the information desk over there. And we've got the train times there as well. And over here. So let's go and have a walk around. So I'm gonna go and I'll update you with something else in a bit. So right now I'm walking through Central Park. So go for a little walk and show you around. Central Park Zoo. Oh. Well, that's the zoo, that little place was the gift shop. So peaceful. I wonder if you can see that seal. Look at that. That was amazing. So right now we have decided to come to the zoo in where are we? I've totally lost on where we are. In Central Park Zoo. So I'll be taking you around there after seeing that amazing seal from before. It was really good, so we thought we'd pay a little visit. It was only $12 to come in, so it was meant to be $18, but I don't know why it was reduced so much. But what an absolute bargain. So I will show you some of the animals when I get to them. So right now I'm in the tropic zone, looking at some parrots. How cute are these parrots? And I'm going to show you what they actually are, the parrots, what they're called and stuff. So we've got this. Look how amazing they are. So cute. It's like he's eating something. So it looks like I'm in a rainforest right now. This is amazing. I don't know what's down here, but nothing too fascinating by the looks of it. Oh, he's up there, this bird. I don't know what he is yet. I'm gonna zoom in and show you. Hope you can see him. But I'll show you this one. There's another one just over to the left of me, so I'll show you him. There he is. He's hiding. Look at that. He's so pretty. So these things are probably the most dangerous fish ever. These are piranhas. These are absolutely mad. It's really bad reflection of these. Look at that. Evil fish. Evil. So I'm at the turtle part now. Look how cute he is. Oh, he walks so slow. What a sweetie. Oh, look, a bird's flown in. Where's that bird? There he is. That has just randomly flown in. But the turtle's gone walkabout. I don't know where he's gone. Over here we have something else. I don't know what these guys are. It's some sort of bird. I'm not sure what they are at all, but yeah, very, very cute. Oh, he's only got one leg. Oh, he hasn't. He's got two. He's hiding the other one. So I was just walking away and this bird has just laid here. How pretty is that bird? Oh, look, he's so cute. That is an absolutely incredible sight to see. I've never been so close to a bird, but that is absolutely wicked. So, so pretty. So right now I'm looking at a snake. I've just been to like a bat cave, but I couldn't film in there because it was too dark and you couldn't see anything. But look at that bad boy. He's huge. And this is what he is. That's what he is. But He is absolutely massive. So these are lemurs. I don't know if you see this very well. There's two of them right there. I think they're sleeping. But they are so cute. That is what it should look like. So, so sweet. There's another one there as well, but he's got his back turned to me. Typical. So in this tree right now, I think we have a peacock. But yet again, he's got his back turned to me. But he's so pretty, look at that. So, so pretty. And I don't know what these pink birds are up here. But they're quite nice too. There he is. Oh, he's done it again. So these are, I'm not sure what these are, but they are very cute. And that's if you can see them, they're always hiding.
Those are mongoose. Alright girls,
there we go.
Come on. Let's go, come on.
He's cute. Oh look. How sweet. These are mongoose. That's what they're called. Mongoose. Oh, he's gone again. Well, there he is. Another one's gone around the corner. So this mongoose has decided to come to the window. How cute is he? I think he's trying to plan an escape. Oh, he's got a friend with him now. Oh, he's eating something. That's sweet. Top of a bark.
This way, Andrea. Right here. You can see his face.
He is so cute. So I don't know if you can see that, but that is an actual bear. See how big that thing is. He's not exactly moving, I think he's just chilling. That is one big grizzly bear.
Oh, it's a
Yeah. But that is incredible. Never thought I'd see a bear like that ever.
Now they're in the middle of the town. They must be wondering what's going on.
But they get fed all the time and
So we've got some other birds here. Some of them are ducks and I don't know what that is. I couldn't find any information about that, but that is a really nice bird. Got another one down here just chilling. Just chilling in the sun. I think we've got another one over there on some branch. That. Where's that one gone? There we go. That one's cool. Well, he's chilling now. So right now we're looking at a red panda. The sun's so bright today, I hope you can see that. That is what it's supposed to look like. So I'm looking at some turtles right now. Look how many there are on that piece of bark. Wow. I've never seen so many. Just chilling in the sun and in the water. It's so, so cute.
They're big, or is that just a skype? One of their big fat things.
Got some swans here as well, which I didn't know about until now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's something in the water. Is that, I don't know, maybe it's a turtle. Little one.
So I hope you can see this, an actual sea lion. and I need to change my battery on my camera. So I will be back in a minute. Ooh!
Wow.
So right now it's feeding time for the sea lions.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Central Park Zoo and our sea lion feeding and behavioral
session.
It's an exciting time at the zoo as we have two female California sea lions.
Good.
Up on the rocks there, that's Charlie.
Charlie
was rescued off the coast of California by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in 2013. And the Wildlife Conservation Society is proud to be part of that important rescue effort. So we're estimating her age to be about 3.5 years old. Now right up here near the ladder, that's April. April was born at the Bronx Zoo in 1991. That makes her 25 years old.
Wow.
So you can see there's a little difference in size between April and Charlie. Both are female. Now, remember I said it was a behavioral modification session. Well, what do I mean by that? Well, if you've ever played fetch with your dog or given your cat a scratching post, that's all behavioral enrichment. It gives the animal something interesting to do and intellectual to focus on. So, while the keepers are asking the sea lions to perform different responses, I'll let you in on a little secret. Keepers are taking this opportunity to check the daily physical health of our sea lions. You see, just like any other wild animal, they don't want to let other animals know what they're not feeling about, because that means they are subject to prey animals. And since they want to stay away from those as much as possible, it's part of their instinct to hide any illnesses. And because we want to keep our sea lions as healthy as possible, we certainly want to check to see if anything is happening on a daily basis. So that's what the keepers are doing, and you see them, looks like they're giving them a nice pat, or petting them, or asking them to stretch their back, which is beautiful. And you might have seen one of the sea lions get eye drops. This is not something they necessarily need, but we get them used to it. They need solution. So in case they ever do, it's not a strange thing. Because anytime we have to ask our sea lions to do something different, it's really a training session. So we have to train all that into their daily workouts. So it looks like people's getting a nice little petting going on.
Checking her
all
tummy.
Her, make sure, is it all nice and tacked? Are there any new bite marks, any new scratch marks? Because of course we try to make our enclosures as safe as possible, but these are animals and they get along with each other just like people get along. Sometimes they agree, sometimes they disagree. We want to make sure that everybody stays healthy.
There you go. Woo!
Now, you'll notice that people are using their hips up to the sea lion's nose to get the sea lion's attention. And that lets the sea lion know they should take the next time. And if you don't think about it, you'll be rewarded by the fish. So, this is called positive reinforcement. And if the sea lion does not respond to the way the keeper wants them to the command, they simply ignore that behavior. And that is common to all training techniques for all animals. Very much positive reinforcement works for people too. So there you go, trying to do a little high fives there. They told me it's like the center of the rock. Now Charlie is really very enthusiastic. I saw him before him jumping in and out of the water, kind of waiting. And they will just relax. And many times Behavior of doing is satisfied. Yeah, I should look forward to
So I'm still walking around Central Park. What a lovely park it is. Finished the zoo now as well, which was really good. Well worth $12. And I've just had some Dippin' Dots ice cream with popping candy in it. And I think I've got a party in my mouth at the moment. Popping candy going off. Really nice. But this park is very, very nice. So I'm going to go somewhere else now, I think, and I'll catch up with you guys later. So all these people that are waiting to see Donald Trump, there are absolutely loads and loads of people. It's police, absolutely everything. It's crazy. I thought it was Obama, but it's not. Majorly disappointed. So yeah, we'll see if I can catch any more of this. It's quite exciting.
So right now, you see Donald Trump.
So that little clip before had it was Donald Trump leaving Trump Towers in New York. I didn't see him really, but something is probably there on that clip. So yeah, it was pretty exciting. Didn't think I'd see the upcoming president of America. Shame it weren't Barack Obama. That would have been more exciting. So this is Times Square at night. We've got all some more walks of life. We've got Elmo there. We've got Woody. Mario, Minnie Mouse, Olaf, Mickey. Got some dancers over here too. I don't know what they're doing tonight, but I am off to the M&M shop in a minute. Just gonna walk around Times Square.
He's going there!
He's going there!
He's going
there!
He's going there!
I'm going through Times Square and now I'm going to the M&M shop. I should say the M&M factory. Got the New York Police Department over there. place is amazing at night. There's the Pink Panther. American flag light there. It's like somebody just got married. So when I get to the M&M factory, I will update you then.
You got a phone egg bomb?
I haven't.
You got a phone egg bomb? You got a phone? You got a phone piece?
I don't add. I've tried it.
Forgot.
Thank you.
nice.
Yeah.
I like to change
Oh, it's a good one.
presents. Right there, look at it. No, I didn't say that was it.
Thank
God it is, ma'am. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, do any of you have a point? No point.
Watch this whole night. I'll let it go.
Same thing, right?
Oh.
about one of your rings? I know it's a weird question to ask.
No.
I promise I won't disrespect any guy.
Take it off.
Can't say good. How about your ring? I won't disrespect you. This is actually perfect.
Thank you.
M&M World. This is so much bigger than the Las Vegas store. All this merchandise. Beach towels. Little mini suitcases. Hoodies, t-shirts. Big M&Ms. Egg cups. Cup with M&Ms. Pillows, more shirts. Got blue. Another shirt. Mugs. Got loads of stuff in here and I'm loving it, but I'm gonna go in a minute because I want to try and buy something. Yeah, I like that. I really like that, but it's not my size. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna go and pick something, and when I get back to my hotel I will show you what I have bought. Well, then again, I'm gonna go upstairs. There's another level. So I'll get back to you in a minute. So this is floor two. Look at all these M&Ms in these tubes. Wow. All different colours. You've got yellow, red, blue, dark blue, orange. It's like the colours of the rainbow. Incredible. Got some mixture ones here. The speciality mix. Even got the UK. Got some more M&Ms here. This place is absolute heaven for me. Absolute heaven. Summer mix, Liberty mix, orange, dark green. This is, oh my word, this is the best thing ever. Look at that. That's amazing. look at that. That is wicked. Right, so now I am gonna go and pick what I want, and when I get back to my hotel I will show you what I've bought. So now I'm in the Hershey shop, Hershey Chocolate World. Look at all this yummy chocolate, all different kinds. They've even got Twizzlers, Kit Kats that we don't have in the UK. We don't do miniatures, I don't think. Got Hershey's. Got these as well, these packages with loads of stuff in it. Don't like Reese's though. And you've got other chocolates as well. Do with Hershey. You can even smell the chocolate in here. There's that much. This chocolate smell is so intense. It goes all the way to the top. Even chocolate syrup. A Hershey hoodie, Hershey t-shirt, everything Hershey. You can even create your own. That is clever. All these as well. These have kisses up there with a giant Hershey kiss. This mugs, Hershey Kisses pillow, and a bag, and some bears. Even that is cool. Hugs and kisses from Times Square. That is so cool. I really like that. Got all the other sweets here as well. So I'm gonna go now and I will update you in a bit. So for tonight's tea, I'm at TGI Fridays on Times Square, and yet again I've already started it because I'm hungry. I have a 10-ounce New York steak with mashed potato and mac and cheese. So I'm gonna continue eating it and I will speak to you later. So right now I am on top of the hotel that I'm staying in at the Knickerbocker. I think it's called the St. Cloud. Wow. How tall these buildings are. These are incredible, these buildings. I love New York right now. That is amazing. So I'm going to end today's vlog here. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, a subscribe, and leave me a comment. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you very much.